Happy Monday, everybody. Today we are here to chat about the Premier League results from the weekend. And we're talking about a pair of big teams headed in opposite directions. Manchester United looking like title challengers. Chelsea, meanwhile, looking very lost under the charge of Frank Lampard. We'll talk about all that and more coming up on Pitchside with Parker.
Oh, yeah. I'm not the type of brother to play with. See a lot of people acting like a, oh yeah. Old ball players sounding like haters. We the young kings of this generation, oh yeah.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back. Pitchside with Parker. Glad to see y'all again on this Monday morning. Be sure to drop a like before this video even starts. That is one thing I would like to see kind of tick up around here for the new year. Get in the habit of liking those videos. It really means a lot to me, and a like is free to you. Literally, all you gotta do is hit that button. So I would really appreciate it. Also, if you're new around here, you should definitely subscribe because I will be doing another giveaway soon. I have some stuff to give away either if we hit 200 subs or at the end of this month, whichever one comes first. So y'all could get the giveaway sooner if some new people subscribe, if you tell your friends, if you get some more people coming around here. It'll either be 200 subs or end of the month, first one. But either way, a giveaway is coming soon, so just wanted to let y'all know about that. Anyway, let's get into the video, and we're going to start with Manchester United. They beat Aston Villa 2-1 this weekend, and although Liverpool is yet to play today as I'm recording this, United and Liverpool are tied at the top as things stand. It's definitely been a topsy-turvy season for Man United. I mean, you think all the way back to the end of September when they had that lopsided result against Tottenham. But there have been some other bumps along the way too. Obviously, the failures in the Champions League, people calling for Ole Solskjaer's job. They even lost to Arsenal. I mean, they lost to Arsenal. And at a point, that was Arsenal's only win in like 8-game stretch. So yeah, they're a strange team, but at this point in the season, they are joint top of the table and they are looking in very good form right now. They just beat a very good Aston Villa side who have caused a lot of teams trouble this year. And it was a good game. It was an entertaining game. Manchester United going again with that diamond midfield look, which has looked very, very polished at times this season. You know, a lot of people criticize Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, but I feel like he has gotten the best effect out of some of the players who are at Manchester United better than other coaches have. I don't really recall other managers doing similar systems with Manchester United and seeing any success, but right now it's clearly getting the best out of Paul Pogba and Bruno Fernandes. Now, if you haven't seen my last video, I did a best 11 of 2020. If you haven't already seen that, I'll put the link right up here. But I chose Bruno as one of my best players for the year 2020. He has been outstanding this year, and you could probably make a pretty good case that he's been the best player in the Premier League, or at least most influential, maybe alongside Harry Kane, maybe Jack Grealish, Mohamed Salah, but very few people have been better than him in the Premier League this year. As I said, I thought Pogba had a great game. He was looking back to his old magical self, really just being creative, and that interchange between him, Bruno, Rashford, Martial, when they are clicking, it's just so good. And the fact that they were able to do it against a very solid defensive team in Aston Villa was impressive to me. Man United's back line actually looked pretty good as well. I mean, Wan-Bissaka had an assist. Luke Shaw was getting up and down the flanks. And Eric Bailly, out of nowhere, just coming in and having himself a fantastic game. A huge block in the 95th minute to save the 3 points for Manchester United. He was all over the place defensively, and he's another very hot and cold player, much like the Manchester United team, but at the moment, it's all clicking for them. So I think the big question a lot of people are asking is, can Manchester United win the Premier League this season? Now, I think it's probably an outside shot still, but I do think that they have a chance, and that in itself brings me a lot of hope and a lot of excitement. Manchester United and Liverpool is a classic rivalry, so I'm always going to be happy to see that again at the top of the table. I would love Arsenal to be back in the mix, but yeah, we know that that's not a reality right now. I'm just happy that it's not only Liverpool at the top. I think if you looked at the table right before the festive fixtures started, you would have assumed that this year was going to start going in that direction again. However, since, you know, the past week or two, things have evened out a little bit at the top. Manchester United now tied for first. Liverpool's dropped points in a few different games. They've picked up a lot of draws this season. They've still only lost that one game to Aston Villa, but they've dropped a lot of points in their draws, and Manchester United have actually won more games than Liverpool. And then City, by virtue of their win over Chelsea, this weekend, which I will be talking about more later on in this video, they are actually sneaking up there as well. They've still got a game in hand, and if they were to win it, they would be 1 point behind both Liverpool and United. And I think the difference in this Manchester United team is that they have a much improved attitude this season on what I've seen in the past. I feel like they're a lot more competitive. I feel like when they play in big games, they show up more this season. And I do think that's a strength of Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, is that he has proven a few times now that he is able to show up in big games, especially in the Premier League. And I think the attitude and the swagger, especially from the likes of Bruno Fernandes, who has proven to be an outstanding leader at Manchester United and really brought a winner's mentality to that club, that has made a huge difference this season. So that's why I see them actually being competitive in the title race right now. But yeah, it just feels like Manchester United could actually win in one of these big games. The few teams that have been able to push Liverpool and Manchester City over the past couple of years, you know, teams like Leicester, teams like United and Chelsea, even Spurs, at times Arsenal, none of those teams ever really felt like they could beat Liverpool or Manchester City in a big game. Like, I feel like I would always pick Liverpool or City in those games because they have that experience and they have that mentality. It does feel to me like Manchester United are in that conversation. I don't know that it means they will beat them, but they're going to have a great chance to prove it in a couple of weeks. Liverpool play Manchester United Sunday, January 17th. So we are still a couple weeks away from that, but it's coming up soon. And that is going to be potentially a title decider. They still have to play twice this season. So I'm really looking forward to that. And based on the evidence that I have right now, I have to say Manchester United are in with this shout, and I'm really happy to be seeing it. As much as I don't like them as an Arsenal fan, the objective side of me, the football fan in me, they are a fun team to watch, man. And as I've said, it's just nice to have a team other than Liverpool and Manchester City competing for a title. So let's switch gears and talk about Chelsea now, a team very much trending in the opposite direction. Look, it happens every single year. The festive fixture period makes or breaks teams. And this year, Chelsea is one of the teams that it has kind of broken. Coming into the run of games, the last three, which were against Arsenal, Aston Villa, and Manchester City, I think a lot of people knew that Chelsea, despite a very good record, had not proven too much this season because they had only beaten one team in the top half of the table. So this was a real signifier for how Chelsea's season was going to wind up. So it's no surprise that fans are starting to put some pressure on Frank Lampard, and Chelsea fans have a very bitter taste in their mouth now that they've played a couple of top teams in a row and only gotten 1 point from three games. I mean, personally, I don't really think there's a lot of disgrace in tying against Aston Villa or losing to Manchester City, especially the way that Manchester City played. Like, they were just really, really good. And when they play a certain way with a certain swagger that we saw the other day, the way that Phil Foden and Kevin De Bruyne were linking up and just causing so, so many problems for Chelsea, to an extent, there's really only so much you can do. Maybe they were a little upset with the lack of fight, I guess, from a Chelsea perspective, but they just got outclassed in that game. On the other hand, the result that should particularly sting is losing 3-1 to Arsenal. I mean, come on. Now, I didn't do a review for that game. I was gone for the holidays, as I've said, but I don't think coming into that game, anybody thought Arsenal were going to win. I certainly didn't. Based on this season, man, Chelsea should not be losing to Arsenal. And that record that they had against bottom table teams, Arsenal's very much a part of that. So they actually kind of ruined that with the loss to Arsenal. And that seemed to be a bit of a turning point. They seemed a little rattled after that. So it has definitely raised a lot of questions. I think especially people are really questioning Lampard and questioning the new signings. Lot of hate online for Timo Werner, Kai Havertz, Hakim Ziyech. Even Edouard Mendy is coming under some criticism now. I think he was much lauded when he first got to Chelsea. And again, it was a part of that stretch where they were playing kind of poor teams and they were just shutting everybody out, and they had a really good defensive record, but they've been leaking a lot more goals ever since they've been playing better competition. I think the truth is really somewhere in the middle for a lot of these players. Like, I am not as critical as of the starts that Werner and Havertz have had. I mean, maybe it's just because I've been watching a woeful Arsenal team all season, but 4 goals and 4 assists in the league, I'm not too disappointed in that for Werner. Yes, he's had a long stretch where he hasn't scored. I think it's about 10 games now, but I'm really just not that worried about him. He's the type of player that gets a lot of chances, and at some point he's going to string another run together of 3-4 games where he scores 4 or 5 goals. I feel pretty confident in that. And it's just the very like hot take, extreme polar opinions culture that we have that exists on the world as a whole, but also especially with soccer fans. You know, it's always Lampard in or Lampard out, Ole in, Ole out, Arteta in, Arteta out. Give it a minute. Look at the big picture. If you're going to scream for somebody to get fired after every time you lose a game, you're just going to get nowhere as a team. You have to trust the people that are there. You have to trust the players. You know, everybody has bad games. Everybody goes on bad runs. They turn it around eventually. Okay, maybe if your expectation is to win the league, maybe you do need a slightly more consistent striker than Werner, but who's to say he's not going to end up and be that player? It really gets on my nerves the way that people just overhype and then overcriticize, and you have to be one way or you have to be another. Like, have a little bit of balance, man. Take a second, and maybe 3 games later, you're going to be feeling completely different. Take it from an Arsenal fan. Like, I don't know if y'all saw my video breaking down Arsenal, but whenever they had lost all those games in a row, they lost to Burnley. It was looking really, really ugly. I just said, you know what? The circumstances are bad. Can we just give it a minute before we have to make a decision on whether to fire Arteta or not? And guess what? 3 games later, Arsenal have won 3 in a row. Now they're only 3 points behind Chelsea, ironically, and they look like a completely different team. There's a whole different system in place. There's new players playing. And guess what? In another 4 games, it might be ugly again, so I'm not getting too excited right now either. I urge you to have some balance, and that's kind of how I'm feeling about Chelsea in the moment. Could this little run of 3 games have derailed their title chances? Maybe. But were they really in contention from the start? I'm not sure that they were before this little period. And who's to say that they won't be? Again, they could go on a similar run that Arsenal has, and all of a sudden, they're going to be right up there next to Manchester United and Liverpool challenging if some results go their way. So I just think it's too early to say anything like Lampard in, Lampard out. People are really criticizing him. Yes, he spent a lot of money, but we're still only 16 games into the season, not even halfway through yet. And this has been an unprecedented season. There's been so many games and there are so many left to come. So it has definitely been an interesting thing to talk about, to chat about. And, you know, I appreciate everybody for having this conversation with me. Be sure to continue the conversation in the comments as well. Maybe you disagree with me. Maybe you do feel really strongly. If you feel like you're Lampard out, if you feel like, you know, these players have been a complete waste of money, let me know in the comments. Give your reasons. I'd like to hear them. But I think people that just blindly scream for somebody to get fired or scream that somebody's a flop just because they have a few bad games, that's the kind of thing that really gets on my nerves if you're not presenting something with it. But anyway, that'll wrap it up for this one. Thanks for checking this video out. As I said, be sure to subscribe if you're new around here. We are going to be doing a giveaway very soon, either at 200 subs or at the end of the month. So hit that subscribe button, put the notification bell on, drop a like on the video, and I will catch y'all in the next one. Peace.